There are two hills here under the umbrella of a single name. Sometimes a hill conceals another hill behind it, the rail goal. Hill walkers complain of that illusion. Believing they have reached the summit, they discover it lies one layer beyond the high ground they have just reached, a familiar issue for most of us, even if our ambitions are more modest than those of sturdy Munro baggers. Craiglockhart Hill, like many a Scottish hill, has seen a private slice of history striated with pain. A century ago, young men, wounded in body and spirit, spent long months on the north face of this hill, recovering from that great stramash of men in broken, tortured Europe. They knew the lie on all the public posters claimed, the dolce et decorum call by those who never saw the trenches or the blood that broke men's hearts, and their bodies too. This hill hosted their hospital, a retreat for the soul injured, quiet, far from the guns, open to the winds that blow across the Forth, bearing the scent of gorse and that of sea, a wind to dry their tears, make whole again the shattered and the saddened. In these northern nights might men sleep once more, free from torment, from the anger of the guns, far from collective madness. If refuge can bring healing, then it must show to us the image of love through quietus glimpsed.